Hey, Steve Panaz, North American Fishing Club. We're at the West Ronda River in Iceland with our guide, Ole. What's your last name?
Sukis.
You've been fishing Atlantic salmon for obviously a number of years, and you've got a selection of flies. If you had to pick three or four of your favorite flies for fishing Atlantic salmon right here in this river, what would they be?
They would be those flies. Red Francis, very small, this one. And Black Stelta, this one here. And also another kind of Stelta called German Stelta. An imitation of Sunray Shadow. These four flies are very effective here.
Now, a lot of your flies, and this one probably shows it better than any, are actually tied on a plastic tube like this.
Yes.
And sometimes you're using brass and that sort of thing for extra weight.
Yes, or aluminum tubes between plastic and brass.
Or kind of a mid-weight type of thing. So what's the advantage of tying a fly actually on a tube versus tying a fly actually on the hook shank itself?
You can then change the how heavy the tube is, more easier.
Okay.
If you want to make it very light, you use plastic tubes. Medium, you use aluminum tubes. If you want to have the fly very heavy, then you use brass tubes.
Brass tubes. And you're fishing fast water that's relatively deep, so you do need sink tip lines and heavy flies,
yes,
correct?
Yes. Okay. Especially in the West Ronda, the river is very cold, so you need heavy flies or heavy sink tips.
And because the water's cold, the fish aren't as active?
Yes.
So you need to get the fly down?
Yes.
These things are an amazing, almost a work of art when you look at them up close. It says peacock feathers on it. And what type of fur is this? Is it a fox fur or?
Yeah, this is fox hair.
Fox hair?
Yeah. And we have fox hair and goat hair and Arctic runner also.
Yeah, this is a lot thinner hair than the buck. We use a lot of deer hair in the States, and this is a lot finer, but very interesting. Well, thank you. That's been really educational.
It's been my pleasure, Steve.